students, so in previous class we are discussing about standard angles as well as ordered angles. Now to find trigonometric ratios of standard angles as well as to find trigonometric ratios of ordered angles. Now what are standard angles? The angles like 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. Those angles are called standard angles. Whereas quadrant angles, what are quadrant angles? The angles like 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree, 270 degree and 360 degree. These angles are called quadrant angles. Now remember that chart, trigonometric ratios of standard angles chart. Each chart is named before it. Now here in first row angles, in first column trigonometric ratios, angles are standard angles are 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree. Now sine of 0 degree value how much? 0. You know sine 30 degree value 1 by 2, 30 degree radian, pi by 6 radian, because pi value 180, 180 divided by 6, that becomes 30 degree. Okay, sine 45 degree 1 by root 2, sine 60 degree root 3 by 2, sine 90 degrees 1. Okay, similarly cos 0 degree value 1, cos 30 degree root 3 by 2, cos 45 degree 1 bar root 2, cos 60 degree 1 by 2, cos 90 degree value 0. Remember, then tan 0 degree is equal to 0, tan 30 degree 1 divided by root 3. Okay, then tan 45 degrees 1, tan 60 degree root 3, tan 90 degrees not defined, that is infinite. Whereas cot 0 degrees not defined infinity, cot 30 degrees root 3, cot 45 degrees 1, cot 60 degrees 1 bar root 3, cot 90 degrees 0. Okay, then sec of 0 degree value, comma sec 0 degrees 1, then sec 30 degrees 2 divided by root 3, sec 45 degrees root 2, sec 60 degrees 2, sec 90 degrees not defined. Okay, then cosec 0 degrees not defined, cosec 30 degrees 2, cosec 45 degree root 2, cosec 60 degree 2 divided by root 3, cosec 90 degree value 1. So this is the trigonometric ratios of standard angles. So how to remember? If I am proposing you, look here, just simple method. Know how to remember this. Now simply write the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. In all the angles work with you longer, remember that concept. You know, first step is write the number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Step number 2, divide each number by 4. Divide each number by 4. Question number 4 in the divide number 0 by 4, 1 by 4, 2 by 4. 3 by 4, 4 by 4. Correct? Simplify. 0 by 4 becomes 0. This is 1 by 4. This is 2 ones are 2, 2 are 1 by 2. This is 3 divided by 4. That is 4 divided by 4 is 1. Okay, first step, write the number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Step number 2, divide each number by 4. We get 0, 1 by 4, 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 1. Next step, take the square root. Take the square root. In each term, particular term get root of lambda. Take the square root in each term. See, root 0, root 1 by 4, root 1 by 2, root 3 by 4, then root 1. Okay, now simplify. Root 0 value 0. Root 1 upon 4, that is 1 by 2. Root 1 by 2, that is 1 bar root 2. Root 3 upon 4, that is split of the root. Root 3 divided by root 4 is 2. Then root 1 is 1. Okay, so these are the values of sine 0 degree. Sine 0 degree is 0. Sine 30 degree value, that is 1 by 2. This is sine 45 degree 1 bar root 2. That is sine 60 degree root 3 by 2. This is sine 90 degree 1. Is there 0, 1 by 2, 1 bar root 2, root 3 by 2, 1.
easy method. Okay. Then cosine varipetta and angle varipetta reverse them. Reverse. Cos 0 degree ekadina varita 1. Cos 30 degree root 3 by 2. Cos 40 degree 1 by root 2. Cos 60 degree 1 by 2. Cos 90 degree 0. Reverse process. Okay. Then tan. How to write tan? You know that tan is equal to sine divided by cos. We are going to divide but we divide sine and cos. Divide first ratio by second ratio. 0 divided by 1. 0. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2. 2 to cancel. That is 1 by root 3. 1 by root 2 divided by 1 by root 2. That is 1. Root 3 by 2 divided by 1 by 2. 2 to cancel. That is root 3. 1 upon 0. That is infinite value. Not defined. This is tangent. Then cotangent. How to write cotangent? Again, reverse process. E kadina parita 1. Infinite. Root 3. 1. 1 by root 3. 0. Okay. Secant. How to write secant? You know that sec theta is equal to reciprocal of cos. 1 divided by cos. Will cos evaluate? In the reciprocal to what? 1 divided by 1. 1. 1 divided by root 3 by 2. That becomes 2 by root 3. 1 divided by 1 by root 2. That is root 2. 1 divided by 1 by 2. That becomes 2. 1 upon 0. Not defined infinity. Similarly, coset. How to write coset? Reverse process. E kadina parita 1. Infinite. 2. Root 2. 2 by root 3. 1. This is the trigonometric ratios of standard angles chart. This is easy to write. Okay. Sine on the 6 to 1. Cosine parivaga. Reverse. E kadina parita 1. Tangent parivaga. Divide sine divided by cos. Okay. Cotangent for you, tangent with the reverse, e kadina parita 1. Secant to solve one with reciprocal of cos. Cosecant solve one with again reverse. Okay, so remember that chart. That is most important. Already we learned in 10th standard, isn't it? So it is an anthropology. Okay, so next result. Sine of trigonometric ratios. Ignore them already. Standard angles study much will be. Quadrant angles study much will be. Quadrant angles have a group 10, 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree, 270 degree, and 360 degree. So, the next concept is sine of trigonometric ratios. Andre, trigonometric ratios are yaga quadrant the left, yaga sine group 10, whether it is positive or negative or both positive or both negative, you have identified. How to solve? Look here. As you know that in the T ratios of quadrant angles, how to solve? Draw a circle, isn't it? Draw a circle with center is at O. The circle cuts the x and y axis and AA dash. You know already somebody draw. Okay. And BB dash. Respectively, with center is at O, radius becomes R. Take a point at T of x1, be a point on the circle, right? Join OP, OP is also radius of the circle. Then construct from the point P, draw PM is perpendicular to x axis such that angle XOP call it as theta. Now OM lies on x axis, OM distance is x, PM lies on y axis, PM distance is by taking y. Okay. Now from the triangle MOP, okay, sine theta is equal to definition of sine, opposite side divided by what, that is y divided by r, right? Then cos theta is equal to adjacent divided by what, adjacent is x divided by what is r, tan theta is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent, that is y divided by x. Cot theta is equal to reciprocal x divided by y. Then sec theta is equal to reciprocal of cos, that is r divided by x. Cosec theta is equal to reciprocal of sine r divided by y. Okay, equation 1. We are solving it. Based on this, next concept, to find the sine of trigonometric ratios. See the figure. In circle divided into four parts, isn't it? This is first part, this is second part, this is third part, that is fourth part. However, in first part, trigonometric ratios sine n group A. Second part, trigonometric ratios sine n group A. Third part, trigonometric ratios sine n group A. Trigonometric ratios sine value, sine, that is positive or negative sine. Check one. in four quadrant, again in trigonometric ratio, what are the sign of key ratios in four part, right? Four quadrant. There are four parts or four quadrants: first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. Now let us discuss about one by one. Okay, the first part. Now suppose the point P lies in first quadrant. Nori P antakkanta point to first quadrant nalli idre. First quadrant capacity ellina ivaru barutte OA and OB. Complete that part is first quadrant, isn't it? However, in first quadrant, what is capacity of an angle theta? First quadrant capacity ellina start avute 0 degree to up to anybody 90 degree. So here angle theta lies between 0 to 90 degree. Read as theta lies between 0 to 90 degree. In first quadrant capacity 0 dinda 90 degree vagi ide. Remember P lies in first quadrant. In first quadrant capacity of an angle theta 0 degree to 90 degree. Okay. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಜೀರೋ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಟು ನೈಂಟಿ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಆದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಲೈನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ? ಓಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಓಬಿ. ಓಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಓಬಿ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಲೈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಬಟ್ ಓಎ ಲೈಸ್ ಆನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್? ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಓಬಿ? ಓಬಿ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್. ಬೋಥ್ ಆರ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್. ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹೈಪೋಟನೀಸ್? ಹೈಪೋಟನೀಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್, ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್, ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್. ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್. ನೌ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರಂಟ್ both x axis and y axis are positive and r is always positive. Okay, now put those values in equation 1. Shivaraman, therefore equation 1 gives sin theta is equal to y divided by r. What is y? Y is positive, r is always positive. Positive divided by positive, don't cancel it. Positive divided by positive is nothing but plus into plus, that is plus positive. Okay, next, cos theta is equal to x divided by r. X is positive, r is positive, that is positive. Okay, then the tan theta is equal to y by x. Y positive, x is also positive. Positive divided by positive, again positive. Then cot theta is equal to x divided by y. X is positive, y is positive, again it is positive. Okay. Then sec theta, r divided by x. R is always positive, x is also positive. Positive divided by positive, again positive. Then cosec theta, r divided by y. R is positive, r is also positive, that is positive. Observe it. No, I am too. All positive ide. Elle in first quadrant. So remember, if P lies in first quadrant, capacity of an angle theta 0 degree to 90 degree in first quadrant, all trigonometric ratios are positive. Remember, L positive varute in first quadrant. Clear? Okay. Then second concept. Suppose the point P lies in second quadrant. One way P point second quadrant alli iddaga. Observe one. Ee part alli bandaga. In this part, what are the sides? OB side and OA dash side. Isn't it? So OA dash is negative direction of x axis. OB is positive direction of y axis. So that x is negative and y is positive and r is always positive. Hypotenuse is always positive. What is capacity of an angle theta? Angle part is 90 degree to 180 degree. That is theta lies between 90 degree to 180 degree. 0 less than 90 degree less than theta, less than or equal to 180. Why we write like this? That is more than 90 degree. More than 90 degree lies in second quadrant, isn't it? And less than or equal to 180. 180 na agutte less than 180 as well as equal to 180 degree. So in P lies in second quadrant, capacity of an angle theta is 90 degree to 180 degree. X is negative, OB is positive direction of y-axis, y is positive and radius is always positive. Put those values in equation 1. Therefore, equation 1 gives, see what happened. Sin theta is equal to y divided by r. What is y? Y is positive, r is positive, positive divided by positive, again positive. Then cos theta is equal to x divided by r. What is x? X is negative. Then divided by r is positive, positive upon negative, is divided, plus into minus, negative. Then tan theta is equal to y by x. What is y? Y is positive, x is negative, plus into minus, that is negative. Then cot theta is equal to x divided by y. What is x? X is negative, y is positive, that is negative, positive into negative, that is negative. Then secant theta is equal to, no, raise secant theta r by x, r is positive, x is negative, plus into minus, that is minus negative. Then cosec theta is equal to r divided by y. What is r? R is positive, y is positive, upon positive, no, really I have positive value. Cosec theta and sin theta, ivere matra positive bandhu, uludella venike nodi negative. Remember, hence if P lies in second quadrant, only two ratios are positive. What are those? Sin theta and cosec theta are positive. Uludella venike remaining ratios are negative. Sin and reciprocal of sin is what? Cosec. So sin and cosec are made for each other. Sin theta is equal to 1 by cosec theta, or cosec theta is equal to 1 by sin theta, isn't it? So sin theta and cosec theta are positive. Where? In second quadrant. Okay, remaining four ratios are negative. Clear? Coming to the third point. Suppose the point P lies in third quadrant. Third quadrant is the one that observe Mari, see that figure. In third quadrant, what is capacity of an angle theta? Illinda, illivarge. Up to this 180. Illivarge to what again? 270 degree. So, theta lies between 180 degree and 270 degree. More than 180, less than or equal to 270 degree, lies in which part? Third part, third quadrant. However, in third quadrant, observe the line. OA dash lies on negative direction of x axis, isn't it? OB dash lies on negative direction of y axis. So that both OA dash and OB dash are negative direction of x and y axis. Therefore, both x and y should be negative. And R is always, you know, look at radius is always positive. Okay, now put these three values in equation 1. Therefore, equation 1 gives sin theta is equal to what? Y divided by r. What is y? Y is negative, r is positive. Negative upon positive means minus into plus, minus negative. Then cos theta is equal to what? X divided by r. What is x? X is negative, r is positive, again negative. Then tan theta is equal to y divided by x. What is y? Negative. X, negative. Minus into minus, plus positive. Then cot theta is equal to x divided by y. X is negative, y is negative, negative into negative, positive. Then secant theta is equal to r divided by x. What is r? R is positive, x is negative, plus into minus, minus negative. Then cosec theta is equal to r divided by y. R is positive, y is negative, plus into minus, minus negative. Observe this. In third quadrant, two ratios are positive, namely yavadu tan theta and cot theta are positive. Remaining four ratios are
negative. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಟ್ಯಾನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಾಟ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಆರ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್, ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ರೇಶಿಯೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್. ವೆಲ್ ವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರೆಂಟ್? ಇನ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ 180 to 270 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ. ಫೈನಲಿ ಇನ್ ಫೋರ್ಥ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಫೋರ್ಥ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರೆಂಟ್ ನೋಡೋಣ. ಸಪೋಸ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ P lies in fourth quadrant. No, re-observe what is in fourth quadrant. Capacity of an angle theta in our theory, that is in fourth quadrant, 270 degree, more than 270 degree, less than or equal to 360 degree, in fourth quadrant up to this 270, complete circle in more than 360, so that 270 to 360 degree. What are the sides? OA side and OB dash side. So OA lies on which axis? Positive direction of x axis. OB dash lies on negative direction of y axis. Therefore x is positive sign and y is negative sign. What about r? Radius is always positive. Okay, now put those values in equation 1. Therefore equation 1 gives sin theta is equal to y by r. What is y? Negative. R positive. Minus into plus. Minus, that is negative. Cos theta is equal to x divided by r. What is x? Plus. R plus. Plus into plus. Plus positive. Tan theta is equal to y divided by x. Y is negative. X is positive. Minus into plus. Minus. Then cot theta is equal to what? X divided by y. X is positive, y is negative, that is negative. Sec theta is equal to what? R divided by x. R is always positive. X is also positive. Positive upon positive, that is positive. Means plus into plus, plus. Then finally, cosec theta is equal to r divided by y. What is r? R is always positive. Y is negative, plus into minus, minus. Observe this. Now the ratio positive is only cos theta is positive, then sec theta is positive. Remaining ratios are negative. Hence, if P lies in fourth quadrant, in fourth quadrant, have positive cos theta and sec theta are positive. Remaining P ratios are negative. No, cos, reciprocal of cos is sec. Tan, reciprocal of tan is cot. Sin, reciprocal of sin is cosec. In first quadrant, in agute, all t ratios are positive. Yalla positive the first quadrant, that is most important. Okay, problem solve madbekar, you result and apply madkoltive. In the correct time, practice madkoltive. Okay, so there are four quadrants. Remember, P lies in first quadrant, capacity of an angle theta lies between 0 to 90 degree. In first quadrant, all trigonometric ratios are positive. Whereas P lies in second quadrant, in second quadrant, capacity of an angle theta is 90 to 180 degree. Here in second quadrant, only two ratios are positive, namely sin theta and cosec theta are positive. Remaining ratios are negative. Whereas if P lies in third quadrant, theta lies between 180 to 270 degree, then only in third quadrant tan theta and cot theta are positive, remaining t ratios are negative. Finally, P lies in fourth quadrant, capacity of an angle theta 270 to 360 degree, only cos theta and sec theta are positive, remaining ratios are negative. Then recorded. Okay. Yes, dear students, so remember that result. Now here, there are four quadrants. You can explain what is the name? Clean and drawn. There are four quadrants, isn't it? So this is first quadrant, this is second quadrant, this is third quadrant, this is fourth quadrant. Rotation is anti-clockwise direction. Okay. Now here in first quadrant, capacity of an angle theta, you know, is to 0 degree to 90 degree. So in the absolute value for the 90 degree minus theta lies in first quadrant. Okay, remember 90 degree minus the rise in first quadrant. Okay, in first quadrant the I position to go. All trigonometric ratios are positive. All T ratios are positive. Remember, remember. Okay. Second quadrant capacity is to theta lies between 90 degree to 180 degree. Here in 90 to 180 degree, 90 degree plus theta lies in second quadrant, isn't it? As well as 180 degree minus theta lies in also second quadrant, correct? 90 plus theta lies in more than 90 degree. 90 plus theta lies in second quadrant. 180 minus theta lies in second quadrant. In second quadrant, here I have posted for the remember sine theta and cosec theta are positive. If you are time dimension, what is the number? Remaining four ratios are negative. Remaining ratios are negative. In third quadrant, the capacity of an angle theta is the only capacity of an angle theta 180 degree to 270 degree. Here 180 to 270 degree. See that 180 degree plus theta lies in which quadrant? Third quadrant. And 270 degree minus theta lies in also third quadrant. Correct? 180 plus theta, 180 lies in second quadrant plus theta. Add some angle. So that angle lies in which quadrant? Third quadrant. 270 minus theta. This is 270. Minus theta means less than 270. Lies in third quadrant. Third quadrant I have positive to remember tan theta and cot theta are positive. Remaining ratios are negative. Remember. Fourth quadrant, capacity of an angle theta is to 270 degree to 360 degree. 270 to 360 means that is 270 plus theta lies in which quadrant? This is 270 third quadrant plus theta at some angle. That angle belongs to under which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. As well as 360 degree minus theta lies in which quadrant? Up to this 360 minus theta less than 360, that is fourth quadrant. As well as minus theta rotation is clockwise direction. That minus theta also lies in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. Correct? So in fourth quadrant, what are the ratios? Cos theta and sec theta are positive. Remaining ratios are negative. Remember that chart. First quadrant, all T ratios are positive. Capacity 0 to 90 degree. Remember, second quadrant, capacity 90 to 180 degree. Only sine theta and cosec theta are positive. Remaining ratios are negative. Third quadrant, capacity of an angle theta 180 to 270 degree. Tan theta and cot theta are positive. Remaining ratios are negative. In fourth quadrant, capacity of an angle theta 270 to 360 degree. Only cos theta and sec theta are positive. Remaining ratios are negative. First quadrant is only 90 degree minus theta kodidandra, that angle lies in which quadrant? First quadrant, because it is less than 90 degree. Second quadrant, 90 degree plus theta more than 90 degree. Second quadrant, then 180 minus theta less than 180 lies in second quadrant. Okay, third quadrant, 180 plus theta more than 180, 270 minus theta less than 270 lies in which quadrant? Third quadrant. Then 270 plus theta more than 270 lies in fourth quadrant. 360 minus theta less than 360, fourth quadrant. Minus theta, rotation is clockwise direction. Minus theta lies in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. Okay, so this is the sign of the trigonometric ratios. Again, short and straightforward. How to remember? See there. X axis, x dash axis, y dash, 1. Four quadrants. This is first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. This is A, first quadrant A. A means all T ratios are positive. Second quadrant, yes. Yes means what? Sine theta. You know that by way to reciprocal of sine. What is reciprocal of sine? Cosec. Sine theta and cosec theta are positive. Then third quadrant, T. T stands for tan. Reciprocal of tan is cot. Tan and cot are positive. Then fourth quadrant, C. C means what? Cos, not cot. Cos and reciprocal of cos is set. A S T C rule. Remember A S T C rule or quadrant rule. A first quadrant, S second quadrant, T third quadrant, C fourth quadrant. In first quadrant, all T ratios are positive. Second quadrant, only sign, yes means sign and reciprocal of sign. What is reciprocal of sign? Cosec. Sign and cosec are positive. Third quadrant, T. T means what? Tan and reciprocal of tan. Hot. Tan and hot are positive. Fourth quadrant, C. C means what? Cos and reciprocal of cos is sec. Cos and sec are positive. So how to remember? A means all. Remember. S means students. Just to remember that statement. Then T means take. C means coffee. All students take coffee roll. Antropodically. All students take coffee roll. All means all T ratios are positive. Students, yes, means what? Sign and cosec are positive. Take, T stands for here. Tan and cot are positive. C means what? Cos and sec are positive. Remaining ratios are negative. Remember, all students take coffee roll. Or we can say that all students, one more statement, all students attend trigonometry class roll. All students attend trigonometry class roll. Or you can remember, all students take coffee roll. And again, what I do? That is most important in preparing. Okay? So, next class, we will discuss about problems based on standard angles as well as ordinary angles. Okay?